Hello everyone, and welcome back to the Hunter Training Garage. Today we're going to take a look at the Hunter Scissor Alignment Lift and the standard operating procedure for this equipment. The Scissor Lift family from Hunter comes in a variety of different wheelbases and weight capacity to fit your needs, including a new longer wheelbase option and an available harsh duty option for enhanced corrosion protection. In today's video, we'll talk about pulling the vehicle in onto the lift rack, we'll use the wheel chocks to secure the vehicle, we'll raise the vehicle up into the air, and we'll talk about the swing air jacks and lifting the vehicle up off of the runway surface. After that, we'll talk about lowering the vehicle back down to the floor using proper lowering techniques. Let's get started. So I have our car parked here in front of the lift rack, and I'm pulled up nice and square with the runways. I'm going to use our off-camera spotter to give me some hand signals as I pull the car onto the lift rack to make sure I don't get too far off to one side of the runways. Once we pull up onto the lift, we're going to park just short of the front turn plates to get set up for our forward roll for our alignment check. So now that we've brought the vehicle in onto the lift and we've used our wheel chocks to secure the vehicle, let's talk about the controls for using this lift rack. So on our rack console, we have three simple controls. We have a raise button, we have a lower button, and we have a lock release button. The raise button will raise the lift up into the air. The lower button will allow us to lower the lift onto the locks. And the lock release button will allow us to unlock the locks to lower the lift back down to the floor. Here on the right-hand side, you might notice that we have a couple other controls. These are add-on features with this particular lift rack. Our first one being our power slide feature, which is pneumatically controlled turn plates and slip plates, and our inflation station feature that allows us to air up the tires prior to our alignment. Both of these are additional features to our fully integrated alignment system, which is a wireless communication package that allows the aligner to communicate with the rack console. So now that we're familiar with our controls here at the rack console, let's go ahead and raise the vehicle up so we can start our work. When raising the vehicle, we want to come up slightly higher than our comfortable working height, so when we come back down, we can ensure the vehicle is on the locks. Let's go ahead and demonstrate that for you. So when I come here to the rack console, we're going to go ahead and hold the raise button, and that's going to raise the vehicle up. And you'll start hearing some clicking noises. Those are those locks engaging. And we have locks throughout the entire working height of the lift here. So I'm going to come up slightly higher than that comfortable working height for the service we're going to perform. It's going to be right about there. So we're going to go up a little bit higher here. And we're going to set the vehicle back down on the lock. So you hear that beeping that the rack console is making. That's a warning saying that the lift is not on the locks. We have to hold our lower button. And once we've held our lower button for about 3 seconds, the rack comes down just a couple inches, it grabs the locks, and comes down no further. So at this point, it's safe for us to go underneath the vehicle. So now that we have our vehicle up in the air, let's talk about our swing air jack. There's a couple controls we need to talk about first before we start using this. Number one is our pivot lever, which is located on the far right-hand side of the jack, and that's the lever that's going to allow us to pivot the jack down in position so we can raise the vehicle. Now just a point of note, while it's up in its stowed position like this, we are able to roll this through the length of the rack here so we can position this under the vehicle so we can match up with our lift points. So let's go ahead and pivot this down. We're going to grab our pivot lever here on the right side. We're going to pull that over to the side. And you see as I lower this down, I can hear that lock into place. There's also a couple telltale indicators here on either side. So you can see we're in the locked position here. We're in the green with our little yellow indicator there. That means our swing air jack is locked into position. So if it's ever in the red position, that means that the jack is not locked and not stowed all the way into the operational position. So to ensure that, when we use our pivot lever, we're going to push all the way down and make sure that locks into place. So I don't want to try to use the jack if either one of these telltales are in the red. Okay, I want to make sure that both of those are in the green, as they're shown here. Okay, so let's talk about some of our other controls. We have our unlock lever here. That's going to work the lock ladders here on the jack itself. And then we have a lock reset lever here that'll show you what that's for here in just a second. So let's go ahead and get our jack into position. So we're going to find our lift points here on this vehicle. They're right about there. And we're going to use our levers down here on the bottom part of the jack. And this is a two-handed operation, so we're gonna push forward to raise the jack up, and then we can pull back to lower the jack. So once we've got our lift points identified there, we're gonna go ahead and lift up a little bit. We're gonna position our jack pads here on our working beam. So get that matched up with our lift points there. And then we're gonna use our handles down at the bottom. We're gonna push towards the middle of the rack. That's gonna raise the jack up. And you can hear those lock ladders engaging there as well. So we do have locks on this swing air jack as well to secure the vehicle once we've got it raised. So we can raise it up to a comfortable working height to perform whatever service we might be performing. And again, similar to the actual lift rack here, we're gonna come up slightly higher than that comfortable working height so we can come back down onto the locks. So I'm gonna take my two handles here, I'm gonna pull them back towards me to lower. And that's gonna lower the vehicle down onto the lock. So you saw the vehicle come down slightly and then stopped. So we're engaged here on our lock ladders there. So now we're safe to go about our service on this vehicle. So now that we've completed our work on this vehicle, let's go ahead and bring it back down off of the swing air jack so we can bring the vehicle back down to the floor. So to start that process here with the swing air jack, we're gonna have to come up off of the locks to disengage the locks so we can bring the vehicle back down. So that's as simple as taking our handles. We're gonna raise the working beam slightly. So we're gonna see the vehicle raise just a little bit here. And once that's happened, we can take our unlock lever here for our locks. We can unlock there. And now our locks are disengaged. So when I pull the levers back towards me, the vehicle is gonna come all the way back down to the runways. You see this vehicle starts coming back down as soon as I pull those levers back. So earlier I mentioned this lock reset lever. If at any time during this process I need to reset the locks so I can set the vehicle back on the locks, maybe there's something else I need to service here on this vehicle with that process, I can take this lock reset lever. We can push that over to the side. That resets our locks here. So now when I come back up, you can hear those locks re-engage. And we can set the vehicle back onto the locks there on the swing air jack. A very handy feature to have, it allows us to be able to use the locks throughout the entire range here on our swing air jack. So we'll go ahead and bring the vehicle back down. We're gonna come back up. Once again, we're gonna come up off the locks. We'll unlock our locks there with our lock lever. And we'll pull those handles back towards us to lower the vehicle. And once we bring our working beam down, once we get pretty close to that stowed position, we're gonna go ahead and stop and we're gonna stow our jack pads here. Make sure that those are slid all the way in. And we always wanna make sure that the pointy end of the jack pad is pointed towards the center of the lift. That way when we pivot our swing air jack down to put it back in the stowed position, we're not gonna run up with any sort of binding issues here on the side on the lift rack here. So we'll go ahead and get those stowed. And we'll bring our working beam all the way back down. You'll hear our locks reset since we're back down here in the home position. And now from here, we can grab our pivot lever, pull that over to release, and we can lift our swing air jack up, and we can stow that back into its home position. So now that we've brought the vehicle back down off of the swing air jack, let's go ahead and bring the vehicle back down to the floor so we can return it to our customer. To do that, we're gonna raise the vehicle slightly to disengage the locks. We're just gonna come up a couple inches. You'll hear our warning beeper there telling us that we're not on the locks. So to disengage the locks totally to bring the vehicle back down to the floor, we're gonna hold our lock release button. And then at the same time, we're gonna hold our lower button to bring the vehicle back down to the floor. So again, this is a two-handed operation here. We're holding our lock release button and holding our lower button at the same time. See that vehicle coming back down to the floor. So now that we've lowered the lift and brought the vehicle back down to the floor, let's go ahead and back it off the rack so we can return it to our customer. I'm gonna go ahead and remove our wheel chocks, and with the help of our off-camera spotter up there, he's gonna give me some hand signals so I can back the vehicle straight off the rack so we can get this back to the customer in a timely manner. So we'll pull our wheel chocks out and we'll go ahead and hop into the car and get this backed off the rack. So those are the standard operating procedures for the Hunter Scissor Alignment Lift. For more information on this product and the rest of the scissor lift family from Hunter, visit our website at hunter.com or reach out to your local Hunter representative. Thanks for watching.